this is my little tractor. We're going to look at not overheating but running too hot today. I think I know what the problem is. I think it's the thermostat. It's like I say, it's not overheating, but it is running a lot warmer than I'd like. So I'll show you what I mean. See, it's running over the centre. Two lines is not the ideal position for it, but this will, it's still getting warmer. It'll sneak up. It doesn't get to the hot. It doesn't overheat. It doesn't warm up too quickly. So I don't think it's a head gasket. It's not losing coolant or spitting coolant out. And if I turn the heater on and have it on full, I can control the temperature. So to me, it suggests that there's a thermostat problem. Basically, a quick overview, I suppose, of a cooling system is you've got two circuits. You'll have a short circuit, and then there's a thermostat which shuts off the big circuit. The big circuit goes through the radiator. I'll try and put a graphic up on that. The idea is the short circuit helps the engine warm up quicker, gets it up to operating temperature. The thermostat then opens and controls the flow of coolant through the large circuit. Now the fan can act on that, and that maintains the engine temperature. Thermostat lives just in there. See that flange? So it sits in this casing here, or casting. I suspect that's not opening, which is why it warms up okay. Normal time, doesn't warm up quicker than it should. It just then keeps going. But it also explains why when I turn the heater on, it can control the temperature of sorts, because I'm basically adding the second circuit, a bit like the fan, because obviously there's a heater matrix with a heater blowing going through it, and that's what's helping keeping it cool. So now we think we know it's the thermostat. The next problem is there's two different types of thermostat for this EX35. It's a Coyote tractor, and they can't tell me which one it is. So I've got to take the thing out to find out whether it's there's a long type or a normal size type. I think I've got the later small type, but I won't know until I take that out. So obviously to do that, I've got to let it cool down a bit. Although this is fairly cold, that part of it won't be. And when I crack that open, I don't want it spewing its guts out. So what I'm going to do is I'll let it cool down, and then I'm going to drain the coolant down to just below the level of the thermostat, sort of somewhere near there. So I don't need to take it all out. Luckily on this, around the other side, there's a little drain valve with a pipe, so I can put that into a funnel, drain the coolant out. Hopefully not too much mess. Some vehicles you haven't got that, and it's just a case of cracking off the bottom hose, or if you can find a plug higher up, perhaps. Maybe even you'd pull that off, but you'd have to protect the alternator. You don't want that getting wet, but you could perhaps pull that off and funnel it out the way, just to drain the coolant down to below where you're going to be working. Ideally, you'd take the whole lot out, but I say I'm just taking it out to find out what one we've got. Then they're expensive. They're something like £35 plus another £30 delivery, because they're not available in the UK. You have to order them. But it's a thermostat. Normally you're looking at £10. So I'm going to take it out, measure it, and see if there isn't an alternative, cheaper option. As long as it's the same temperature, opening temperature, and the same dimensions, we should be golden. But we'll see if we can pull that one off. But first, I'm going to let this cool down, and then I'll drop the coolant down. I'm just going to be draining coolant into a bucket. You don't need to see that. All right, so coolant's out. I've taken about a bottle and a quarter of a bucket. That's down below the level of the thermostat now, because I've taken this top hose off. Sometimes you don't have to, but on this one, the hose comes up here and then goes across to the top of the radiator. So it's actually blocking access to this bolt here. And there's a nut on the other side, but there you can see the thermostat, a little dribble of water on top of it, or coolant on top of it. I've sprayed this nut, and I sprayed the clamps with a little bit of maintenance oil. This stuff's brilliant. I've had it before where clamps been on there for donkey's years. I mean, this is a 2008 machine, never been touched, and then you get iron and do it, and it just snaps. Same with them nuts. It's a 12 mil head. I snapped a few of them in my time. So a little bit of oil. I'll leave that to soak for a bit. And then I'll undo that top flange, and hopefully that'll expose the thermostat. I've got to try and save the gasket, because that's something else. We have to make one of them, because they haven't got any. So even if I do find an alternative thermostat, we've still got a gasket to make. But yeah, it's not a problem. This is coming off now. that nut was a little bit tight. And sometimes, this may sound a bit weird, but sometimes if something, you're starting to undo a nut and it just won't move, try tightening it up just a little tiny bit. Sometimes it just cracks it off a little, and then you can get it out and then wind it off by hand. Doesn't always work, but I've had a lot of success with it in the past. The gasket's separating wrong. Some of it's sticking to the top, the flange, and some of it is sticking to the casting. So what I've got to try and do now, this is going to be impossible to film, but I'm just going to use some feeder gauges, really thin, because I don't want to cut that gasket. I am going to replace it, but for now it's going to have to go back together and hopefully keep this serviceable to some point so I can still use it. But basically what I'm going to do is find the thinnest one I can get that's got the strength to just separate it from the casing, get that all the way around, and it'll either stay on the block or it'll come off. So the progress so far, I don't know if you can see this, we're free from there all the way around, and there's maybe 10 mil, what would that be, half an inch, just hanging up. But there's a plate here which I can't get through, so I'm going to have to work a feeler gauge in diagonally to try and get it underneath just to lift it up. But we're more or less loose. There's my feeler gauge disappearing. I've just got to get that last bit out, and then hopefully I've saved most of that gasket. We have a winner. It's not too bad. I can put it back as a temporary measure, but it's not a permanent thing. But now, at least I've got a decent template. Just worked it around with a feeler gauge. What are we looking at? 0.2 mil. Eighth thou is that? Normally dealing millimetres. But however, yeah, just gently rub it round, because you can do it with a knife, but then you risk cutting it. And if you did want to reuse this, say it's something you just couldn't get, or you're stuck somewhere, a knife will gum it all up. Took a bit of a hit there, but that's why I try not to lever these things out with a screwdriver. There's our thermostat. That's the big one. Alright. We'll see. I'm hoping there's some manufacturing marks on here that give the game away, but I'm going to clean this up. I'm going to try and test this as well. I'm going to stick it in some I think it's meant to be 82 degrees. There we go, 82 degrees. So 82 degrees. That should open. That bit there. Should open, but this, I think there's two bits to this. That's the bypass. So now I've got to try and find an alternative. I've taken a micrometer and taken all my measurements. I'm going to try and find one in the UK if I can. If not, I'm going to have to wait. Seems to be the pain with these Coyote machines. Getting parts is a bit of a nightmare. But I'm going to put this back together now, so at least I can still use it. So it's not overheating, it's just running hotter than I'd like. So we're a few days after I pulled this out. thermostat's going to be a few weeks now, but I still need to use this tractor, so it's not overheating. We're going to put it back together again. This is the old gasket, and as you can see, it's taken a few hits. I'm not going to put that back in. You can see there's chunks of it missing, and it's well used. But that's no stock item. I've got no idea when that's coming in, so I've made one. This is gasket paper, so that should get me out of trouble. So I'm going to stick this back on now, and then we'll bleed this out. Thermostat's back in. Simple reversal of removal. Gasket's going to go on. Flange will go on. I'll do the two nuts up, put the hose back on, and start filling the coolant. There's the flange back on. Fairly simple. Bolt and a nut. Tighten it up evenly. Hose is going to go on next. Just a little note on these. Sometimes these right angled hoses, don't stick that one on first and then try and get the long side on. It's a lot easier to push that in and then lever that down on top of the fitting. Just makes the job a little bit less of a faff. Right, hose is on. Screw clamp there. Another one there. Don't over tighten them, because obviously this is rubber.
you cut through it. Antifreeze is in, and what I like to do with when I'm refilling a cooling system, if you haven't got a vacuum filler, you're doing it manually, is get some antifreeze in, get it up to a level where any air can sort of sneak past, and then just leave it. So if you're going to tea break, lunchtime, overnight, best thing, late night on a Friday, make this the last thing you do, and then when you come back in on to the workshop on a Monday morning, that would have gone down a bit. Any air just makes the whole process a little bit easier. But obviously, a lot of time you can't do that. But now, I'll leave that like that. I'll let it sit for a bit. Put the kettle on, come back, and then carry on.
So the coolant's in. We've just got to run it up till it's hot now. Top the radiator up as much as I can get in it. And then the idea is you heat cycle it, get it up to temperature, and then let it cool down. And that's supposed, fingers crossed, to get all the air out of this one. There's no real bleed screws or anything that I can find, so we'll see. But good news is, gasket's fine. No leaks. So yeah, onto a win, I'll just bleed this out, and that should be the end of this one.
That was fairly painless. Got it up to operating temperature, no leaks. Get it hot, and then according to the manual, turn it off, let it cool down, and then we'll check that level there. So far, so good. If you like this sort of thing, have a look at this video here. I'll see you on the next one.